Thank you, Tarun. And I would be, I have recently, it has been only 1.5 years since I started my private practice. So it is a difficult step. So I don't have any financial disclosures. Most of the slides, and this is with the inputs of Dr. Dipankar, who was supposed to be here, but he's not here unfortunately. So I don't have any financial disclosures to whatever we were not taught. Okay, these things were never taught to us. So first of all, if you want to jump into private practice, think that whether you are a right material for private practice. You have other options like academic institution, corporate chains, government jobs. You can go to charitable. But because the private practice needs that you should be a hard worker, you should be a people's person. It's more of a social gathering that you have. The person should be able to handle stress and he should be a multitasker. Challenges initially to start with is technology. Range and competence is that it is very easy to say, hey, you will get a receptionist at any time. I have been struggling with the receptionist since 1.5 years. I haven't got a receptionist yet. Regulations, the moment you do something which is commercial, everybody from the police wala to the Hutta or Haryana Urban Development Authority will come to you and ask for money. The regulations are necessary. When you are new, you can get to be bogged down by the market forces. If you are not big, everybody would try to push you down. And this regards the companies also. So when I started practice, I did a initial market survey. I had Medanta on my left, and then I had stone throw away, I had Artemis Hospital. These are big hospitals, and then Fortis also. So whether it was the right decision, I still don't know yet. But eventually it will be. So I looked at the number, I just googled ophthalmologist in Gurgaon. So when you see private setups, Google gives you a good idea. So in my 2.5 kilometer of square area, which is quite a big area, you don't have any ophthalmologist except me who is practicing privately. Sometimes there are people who don't want to go to big institutions. So Google gave me a fair bit of idea, yes, that okay, this is the ophthalmology setup here, and people search on Google. If you do this in Delhi, the 800 square meter considered is a good area. Within 800 square meters, you will have 2 or 3 ophthalmologists sitting. So that's to look at the competition. So I had to visit senior practitioners, as you might not get chance later, and they are so snobby also at times. That's okay. I assess the population and practice profiles, their social and professional relationships, and how to build them. I tried to explore funding options from them, but couldn't get any money from them, though I could have invested in their thing. Look for possible partners. Better to look for possible partners among your peer. You should not look for possible partners whom you think that will not. You should look 10 years ahead. You should not be myopic enough to see that, okay, let us get through this phase and then we'll see another partner. Then there was a thing that where to start. Should I go to my hometown? I was in Bangalore at that time. Should I come back to Gurgaon? Or should I go back to a smaller city? Or should I stay in a bigger city? So hometown, what happens is that your parents must be knowing people. They must have a large base. The referral gets built up, that's an automatic referral. Though they will not come early, they will eventually come. In smaller cities, it's not a tapped territory. You are a specialized person sitting there. Sometimes you go to a smaller city, you are the only specialized person doing ophthalmology practice there. But at times there is less acceptance to the specialized work also, because eventually once the patient in the patient's mindset, it's said that they locks up the bus cataract karte hain. That this doctor does only cataract. If you have a retina problem, you have to go somewhere else. That mindset, it will not work in a smaller city, and that will lose your patients. In bigger cities, you have saturation, you have competition, but you have to look for the expansion, sharing, merger. There's so many things in a big city, but yes, the ultimate thing is that it is so crowded, it is a little difficult to survive. Now you have zeroed in, I zeroed in on Gurgaon, and then what to do? Should I buy some property or should I do it my home clinic or should I rent? So I decided to open a home clinic at my home only. The basement is a clinic. You also look for easy approachability. You should also look for visibility. You should also look for parking. It should be free. People don't like to pay for parking, even if it is 1/6, 1/20th of the fees they are going to pay you for the consultation. You have to look at the neighborhood also. You should not be in a neighborhood which is unstable. People don't like to come there. Also look at when you're buying, whether you have any spaces of OT waiting or you can expand or not. This is what you thought, that yes, I'll put my OT here, I'll put my center here. But apart from that, there are certain legal and regulatory authorities which will come and tell you that you can't do that. So it's better to learn about them. You can go to their website, the respective municipal corporation website of your city, and see what are the regulations in your area. Please follow these regulations, otherwise the bill that they give you for not following these regulations is quite hefty. Then comes the difficult part. How do you buy equipment? Initially, I thought I'll concentrate funding for the surgical equipment as my mainstay and then economize on the OPD thing. But I didn't. I spent a good amount on OPD thing because first I had to build a good diagnostic unit, then only take the patient for surgery. FACO has been the bread and butter for each and every ophthalmologist, and it's for me also. I am attached to two multi-specialty hospitals where I operate, and they give you an initial expenditure. You can spend the money earned from there onto your practice, and at initial practice, no third party administrator will give you a cashless facility. So you have to approach these big hospitals to operate there, and if the patient wants cashless facility, you have to go there. Then was the dealing with the equipment companies. The companies are here to do business. They are nobody's brother or sisters. So it is always better that if two or three people are starting practice, you can consult a colleague and get a bulk deal, and you can better negotiate them. Many companies like to take a deferred payment. You pay them in PDCs. You pay them X amount of the 1/10 as a booking amount. Tell them I'll pay you in a 10%. Percentile thing, you can charge, they can charge a simple interest also. Don't get biased by the name of the company. Don't say that I only want to buy a Zeiss microscope. Look for Tagaki also, look for Labomed also, look for Appa also. Then you feel if your budget is good enough, then go for it. Feel and use every equipment. These people don't mind keeping their equipment at your place for a demo. If you are serious buyer, they will never mind keeping their equipment at your place. Make sure that all maintenance and upgrade terms are penned down in your records and they are signed by the company also. So this is what I plan to do in the next 5 years. I already have an essential part here, which is a slit lamp, ARK and applanation. So the second line equipment is because I am not operating at my own center yet. So the A scan I usually do at the center where I operate. The second line would be a A-scan, a lens meter, a OT microscope and a FACO machine. This will cover my cataract part. As I grow, I would invest in a third line thing, would be your OCT, topography, FFA, HPF, optical biometry, and then I will start sharing the resources also. So this is a plan for the next 5 years. Let's see how it goes. Rewards, I am standing here in front of you and speaking about this. That is the best thing. And I get to see happy patients. That is very good. And this private practice gives me independence also. Thank you so much for your attention.